Captain Mike Rotunda coming up next on the main event. Don't forget tomorrow night, phenomenal card, 7:30 in Greensboro, North Carolina, in the Coliseum. We hope to see you there, 7:30 tomorrow night.
He is a foreigner from Syracuse, New York. He weighs in at 240 pounds. For wrestling fans, this is Captain Mike Rotunda.
Captain Mike Rotunda with a, I guess because you're here, he's got the Varsity Club singlet on.
Hey, as you know, the only reason why the Varsity Club broke up is because the NWA couldn't handle it anymore.
This should be, you're right. You're exactly right about that.
This is going to be a whale of a match. We have a former NWA World Heavyweight Champion and a former World TV Champion. Pick a winner for me, Jim.
Well, I'll tell you something. I'm going to go out with Mike Rotunda. Well, surprised you, didn't I?
You certainly did. But that shows me your wrestling expertise. I am too. You go with a two-sport star anytime.
Well, that's what I'm going on. But Tommy Wildfire Rich has wrestled his way back into great shape. A man that I think we could say without any malice, he kind of fell from grace. He wrestled in regional operations. He let his weight get a little bit out of hand. He has worked very, very hard. He's back in phenomenal shape. His one loss record since he's been back has been excellent. His matches with Lex Luger have been real tests for the total package. Tommy Wildfire Rich has looked better in recent weeks than we have seen him since the early 80s, quite honestly. But Rotunda, as you said, he may have been one of the greatest TV champions of all time, and he has got a great amateur background. If he'll use it, he has the advantage with Rich. If he wants to fight, Tommy Rich may be the victor in that situation.
You hit the nail on the head. What Rotunda has to do is keep Rich poised, because if Rich goes off, they don't call him Wildfire for nothing. That's what makes him so dangerous.
Side headlock, but Wildfire pushes Rotunda off. High hip, taking Rotunda over. Nice move by Tommy Wildfire. Rich follows with a dropkick and another. Rotunda now with a time out, so to speak.
Well, Jim, it's not a time out. You break the guy's patent. He had everything going his way, Tommy Rich. Mike broke the patent, and he'll take as much time on the floor as he wants. He knows how to use the floor, and he knows how to use the count.
Fans, the NWA main event tomorrow night, 6:05, Midnight Express on the program. To take on Johnny Rich and the Stargazer. An outstanding young masked man you'll see tomorrow night. And the Steiners and the SST for the World Tag Team Championship. The Savage Samoan SWAT team with the Big Kahuna making a run for the title on the main event this Sunday night, 6:05, against the Steiners. Good side headlock there by Tommy Wildfire Rich. This Kendall Windham. Kendall Windham doing a little scouting here. I wonder who's he scouting? Let's say that.
Probably both, because he knows that they're both stars of the NWA. And the NWA, it has the most competitive of all the federations. And I'll tell you what, if I was Kendall Windham, I'd be writing this down.
Rich, that right hand, he had that hand clenched, the fist clenched, ready to go. Tommy Young talking to Kendall Windham. Wendell is observing thus far. Another collar and elbow tie-up, and Rotunda now with the advantage. Takes Rich down, got two out of it. Rolls him back over. That's the amateur back grab, but not that foot. That's a Kevin Sullivan influence.
It certainly is, and I'm like you, Jim. Win at any cost. You know, the thing about Mike Rotunda, the longer it goes, the better chance Mike Rotunda is going to have to beat Tommy Rich. If Tommy Rich gets a quick one, that's where Mike is in danger.
It's been an interesting year for both these athletes. I got to think Tommy Rich has got to be considered as one of the comeback athletes of the year for his great effort since he's returned to the NWA. But Rotunda's had a great year as well. In 89, he has been one half of the World Tag Team Champions. He missed the elbow, and he's been the World TV Champion. Nice move, good reversal by Rotunda. Leg grapevine, roll Rich over, and amateur wrestling would have been over.
It certainly would have been. But well, that's the difference. You take the three count here. Let me ask Kendall Windham to leave. I want to say one thing. You know, you said about the great matches Rich and Luger had. I really believe it was the matches with Rich that put Luger on a different plateau. It changed him. It changed his personality and gave him that killer instinct.
You may well be right, because he certainly changed since that confrontation with Tommy Wildfire Rich. Much of that documented right here on TBS.
And he better have that killer instinct Wednesday night, because he was my original pick. But now, as I said, after this big surprise, I think it's anybody's ball game, Jim, when you analyze it.
It is. It's a toss-up. It is going to be a toss-up going into the thing with all the recent developments. That's why you fans around the country should call your local cable company as Rotunda takes a direct shortcut with a referee trying to break it. Just a couple of right hands taken over on Tommy Rich. He missed with a clothesline. Rich with a high-cost body. Could not break on the leg, and that will be the reason I think he didn't get the pin.
That's the reason that Mike Rotunda didn't take a shortcut. He went directly at him. It wasn't a shortcut.
All right, well, he straight right hand was...
It's not a shortcut.
All right, your estimation, it isn't. I'm sure many fans will agree that it perhaps was, but both men back up to the vertical base. This match gone back and forth very evenly.
This is what Mike Rotunda has to do, is keep the fans out of the match. This is Atlanta. This is Tommy Rich's home court. You keep the fans out of it, you get a chance. It's like in Boston, it's the Gardens. When the Celtics play and you go up there, you're playing against 15,000 Celtics.
At the Garden?
At the Garden.
Oh, good move by Rotunda, catching Rich off the rope. He buried the knees in the midsection. The Syracuse Orangemen are playing the Georgia Bulldogs right here in Atlanta in the Peach Bowl. I'm sure Rotunda will be on the 50-yard line for that one as his alma mater goes against Ray Goff's Georgia Bulldogs. Maybe he could be there in Dangerous Dan's Spivey. Spivey's a former Georgian football player. Rotunda comes from a great sports institution. That's what we were talking about. They didn't teach him at Syracuse, I wouldn't think.
No, Mike picked that up in one of the bars around Syracuse. He went to establishment quite quickly. This is what I said. He had to take it to Tommy Rich. The longer the match has lasted, the stronger Rotunda has gotten. He has Rich right where he wants him. He needs a great move, great move.
Rotunda was an honor graduate of Syracuse. He made great A's in pool hall, football, and study hall. Three of his best subjects, but he did get a degree in all seriousness. He likes to wrestle near the ropes because he likes to use them like that. I don't think he's just getting his balance. Right hand by Rotunda. Down goes Tommy Wildfire Rich. The Rich headbutt dangerously low there. Got him in the lower abdomen. Got him there one more time. Rich comes up with a big uppercut. Right hand. Rich now sends Rotunda for the ride. But Rotunda kicks him in the face. Rich set too early.
Great move. Great move. No better place than to kick someone in the face. That takes the fight out of anybody.
Richo back up to the apron. He got a hand it to Tommy Rich. And he is a tenacious son of a gun over the top. Sunset flip. Rotunda can grab the rope. One, two, and Rotunda kicked out. Man, we've had a lot of near falls here. There's a nice suplex.
That's what Mike does better than anybody. It's a quick snap suplex. He doesn't hold the guy up. He turns them over real quick and they don't know where they are. And I think he hooked it, Mike, and you got
it over. But Rich got the shoulder up. The left
just
shoulder.
Barely.
You can see it right there.
Just barely,
the left shoulder came right up. Great camera shot. Taking you right inside the ring. You saw the left shoulder come off the canvas.
You know, there's a lot of things I don't like about Tommy Rich, but you can't take away his heart.
That's exactly right. He has got a great fighting heart. We have documented that he has in his history that to be the second youngest man ever to be the world's heavyweight champion in the National Wrestling Alliance. That is a great, great honor for Tommy Wildfire Rich, a native of Hendersonville, Tennessee, lives right now right here in Hotland.
Could you say he was once and maybe the next future champ?
I'll tell you something, Doc. I wouldn't want to count him out in a big match, and this is a big match right here. Boy, what a collision. Rotunda got the better of it.
That's from his old football background.
Got one that time in the lateral press. I think Wildfire is surprising Rotunda with his great tenacity. Wildfire will not quit after sustaining all this punishment from Captain Mike Rotunda.
Well, what he has done is he's proved me wrong. As the match has gone on, instead of getting weaker, Rich has gotten stronger.
He's in great shape, as we have said. He's really fought his way into competitive physical condition. Ask Lex Luger, you don't feel great, I'll tell you that. And right now, Mike Rotunda, you see, it's Rich with a handful of hair. But it's Rotunda. Well, they shook the lantern.
Where's Kendall Windham?
That's a good question.
Where is Kendall Windham? I want to know this. Something's going on here that's really strange.
We're going to keep an eye on this situation. I've seen this happen before. Somebody dims the light, and then somebody does it literally. Rich with an elbow. It's a twilight doubleheader.
Jim, there's something rotten here in Atlanta, and it ain't Lindbergh cheese.
Foot on the rope, the fast press almost had him with the foot on the rope.
Was his foot on the rope before the three count, Jim? I didn't see it.
It was a three count, I don't think. Well, Rich just tossed the referee over, and now we're trying to drop Rich over the top rope. That should be a disqualification. This one here has become very chaotic. He threw Tommy Young aside, and now Rotunda, there's no referee physically able to officiate this match. There's Rich with a sweeper on Rotunda. Rotunda drops down. Rich falls into the ring. The physical toll on both these athletes is really something here on the super, on TBS, the superstation. Rotunda kicking a referee.
There's something wrong here, Jim. There's something wrong. The lights are out. I thought there was a three count. I thought there was a DQ. The referee's still down. Could Gary Hart have something to do with this? Is he trying to separate the player up after the big surprise they gave him?
I have no idea.
We're going into cold darkness. Is this in the clip?
Fans, we apologize for these technical difficulties. We don't know the origin of them, but we're going to keep our eye on this situation. Snap mare as Rotunda mared right out of the corner by Tommy Rich. Tommy Young is hurt.
Where's the other referee?
There's another ref right there. Tommy Young is hurt here.
I have seen strange matches in my day, but this is the strangest I've ever seen. There's something behind this, and I think it stems from the big surprise Flair threw at Hart.
Nick Patrick's in the ring. They're going to try to help Tommy Young. Tommy Rich, roll up. Referee over the count. Rotunda's got the rope. And Rotunda's going to steal one. Rotunda has stolen this one. And all the controversy and all the confusion, Mike Rotunda has stolen this one.
It's even more than a steal. There's something that went on. Mike pulls him down, gets him set, yelling at the referee. Here comes the referee. One, two, Mike hooks the rope. If anybody has a complaint.
And in this segment, we're going to show you a recent confrontation, verbal confrontation, with Lex Luger and the world's heavyweight champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair. Luger thinks he is by far the greatest athlete to ever grace the squared circle. They say that on his birthday, he sends his mother a basket of applause. He is that pompous. I was interviewing Lex Luger when he asked Ric Flair to join the conversation.